Good day, this is Crypto Cyborg, bringing you bits and bytes of crypto. Guys, feel free to subscribe, like and share and comment. Okay, today in the news we're going to have a look at markets. In the news, 70% of crypto holders started investing in 2021. Bitcoin history, 13-year anniversary. Tether freezes $150 million. And Tesla launches Dogecoin for payments for its merchandise. And then some news flash in the shorts. So let's start off with crypto bubbles in the markets. As you can see, it's mostly a mix of red and green today. With Rose, GLMR, Doge, Near, and OMI up there. It's the highest green bubbles. Let's have a look at the top 10 here. So, mostly red for the day and the hour. Top 20, slightly more greens in the top 20, and in the top 50, a mixture of green and red in the markets today. Okay. So 70% of US crypto holders started investing in 2021. But 70% of crypto holders in US started investing in crypto in 2021, according to the Crypto Perception Report 2020-22 by Huobi Group. The company polled about 3,100 US adults in mid-December 2021. So as you can see, when people started investing in crypto, 12% in 3 months ago or less, 29% 3 to 6 months ago, 27% up to 12 months ago, 21% 1 to 2 years ago, 12% 2 to 4 years ago, and 9% 4 years ago. Respondents did not invest too much in crypto though. 46% have $1,000 or less invested, 25% held between $1,000 and $10,000 worth of crypto. 42% of respondents feeling it was too risky to invest in crypto. 34% concerned about the lack of market regulations. And 24% didn't have enough capital to invest in crypto. So Bitcoin history, 13-year anniversary of the transaction between Satoshi and Alphany. So 13 years ago, computer scientist Hal Finney became the recipient of the first transaction on the Bitcoin blockchain from creator Satoshi Nakamoto. So on January 12, 2009 to be specific, with a Bitcoin white paper a mere 3 months old, Satoshi sent Finney 10 Bitcoin worth next to nothing at the time, now roughly about $440,000. As a test to determine the viability of the blockchain. Finney mined block 70 something and was a recipient of the first Bitcoin transaction when Satoshi sent 10 Bitcoins as a test. They carried on an email conversation between himself and Satoshi over the next few days, mostly reporting bugs and fixing. Finney passed away from amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, also known as Lou Gehrig's disease, in 2014. He would have been 65 years old in 2022. At the time the first Bitcoin was sent, there wasn't even a cash value associated with the crypto asset. Thus, blockchain has accrued more than 701 million transactions as of January 8th. One of the most famous early use cases, exchanging 10,000 Bitcoin for 2 pizzas in 2010. So 13 years ago, Bitcoin and crypto were highly experimental, unproven and largely unknown. Today, regulators across the world discuss how to handle the integration of central bank digital currencies, stablecoins and digital assets into the financial systems. Experts are predicting the price of the crypto assets will hit 100k in 2022, with the potential for even more growth in the years to come. So Tether freezes $150 million. Tether has added three more Ethereum addresses holding more than $150 million worth of USDT stablecoin between them to its blacklist. As a centralized company, Tether is able to blacklist addresses it believes are involved in crime, money laundering, or for any other reason it chooses. The first time blacklist address in 2022. It added 312 addresses to the blacklist last year and has added 563 all up since it first did so in 2017. Tether has not revealed why the three new addresses were blacklisted. However, it has used its power to blacklist addresses involved in cyber attacks and law enforcement investigations. Following the KuCoin hack in September 2020, Tether froze about $35 million to prevent hackers from capitalizing on the theft. And the last story, Tesla launches Dogecoin payment for merch, but there's a catch. So CEO Elon Musk announced that Tesla now accepts Dogecoin as payment for the company's merchandise. Doge eligible products in the Tesla store can be purchased by sending Doge to the Tesla's Dogecoin wallet. The firm also clarified that it is not taking any other types of crypto. Non-Dogecoin digital assets sent to Tesla will not be returned to the purchaser. Items purchased with Doge cannot be returned, exchanged or cancelled. Tesla considers all sales made to Doge as final and cannot be exchanged for cash. The Dogecoin community was quick to respond. Some tweeted that they already purchased items using Doge. A month ago, Tesla confirmed that it was going to start accepting Doge for merch purchases. This resulted in a 25% price increase for the meme coin at the time. A few hours later, after implementing Doge payments, the assets price saw an 18.63% gain. Musk expressed his thoughts about Doge, comparing it to Bitcoin. According to him, even though it was created as a silly joke, Dogecoin is better suited for transactions. He stated that Doge is slightly inflationary and this encourages people to spend it rather than using it as a store of value. Tesla is not the only company implementing crypto payments this year. A survey by Visa shows that small and mid-sized businesses are also set to adopt crypto payments in 2022. So newsflash in the shorts, it's all in a name. If you want to look at the details, just simply pause and search this on Google and go read the full article when your search comes back with the detail. So Bitcoin's rate jumps to all-time high as Jack Dorsey confirms Block's mining system. Pakistan's central bank reportedly wants to ban crypto. Tonga to copy El Salvador bill, making Bitcoin legal tender, says former MP. China aims to separate NFTs from crypto via new blockchain infrastructure. Visa survey shows that 24% of SMBs plan to accept crypto payments. Solana could become the Visa of crypto bank, says Bank of America. Interest wanes in Bitcoin futures ETFs as contracts fall below 5K. OpenSea competitor looks rare, exceeds $394 million in sales. Well, that's it, guys. Hope this was informative. Subscribe to my Telegram channel for future news and instant updates. And that's it. Have a great day. Cyborg signing out.